Okay, students, in the previous section we discussed about acid react with metallic oxides and bases react with non-metallic oxides and all compounds contain hydrogen or not an acid. For example, glucose solution, alcohol solution, HCl solution and H2SO4 solution. In these four solutions, the four solutions contain hydrogen compound, hydrogen element. Okay, in these four solutions, HCl and H2SO4 act as an acid. The bulb glows brightly. But in the case of alcohol solution and the glucose solution, both are contain hydrogen element, but they do not produce H+ ions. The bulb does not glow. Okay, here now the acid or base mixed with water, to form dilute acid or dilute base. Mixing of acid to water drop wise with constant stirring, then that acid is called diluted acid. Or base also, mixing the base drop wise into the water with constant stirring, then that the base is called dilute base, dilute sodium hydroxide, dilute potassium hydroxide, dilute magnesium hydroxide, etc. Okay, this process is known as dilution. Mixing of acid or base drop wise into the water with constant stirring, this process is known as dilution. Then that acid or base is said to be diluted. In this process, some amount of heat is liberated. So these reactions are called thermal reactions, exothermic reactions means in the chemical reaction heat is evolved. Such type of chemical reactions are called exothermic reactions. In exothermic reaction, heat is evolved. So the dilution of acid or base is exothermic reactions. In this process, heat also evolved. Okay, mixing of an acid or base with water result in decrease in the concentration of H2H3O+, means H+ ions. That means decrease the concentration of acidity, acid property. Decrease in the concentration of ions, H3O+, acid ions, and OH- ions, basic ions, per unit volume. Such process is called dilution. Decreasing the concentration of H3O+ ion means H+ ion. Means ion of acid and OH- ion means ion of base. Decrease the concentration of H3O+ or OH- per unit volume. Such process is called dilution. Then the acid or base is said to be diluted. Okay, next one, strength of acid or base. Test for strength of acid or base. Test for strength of acid. Strong acid, strong base. Weak acid, weak base. Test. A test to know whether the acid is strong or not. Okay. Here, fill the first baker A with dilute acetic acid. CH3COOH. And the other baker filled with the other baker B with a dilute HCl. So Baker A filled with CH3COOH acetic acid. Baker B filled with dilute HCl, dilute hydrochloric acid. Okay, in both cases, in both Bakers arrange like this. This diagram, two graphite rods, two colored voids with bulb and connected to the 230 AC plug, 230 voltage AC plug. So in this Baker, this is like a Baker A, it contains CH3COOH, switch on the circuit, current flows through the circuit, bulb glows with low intensity in the presence of CH3COOH, bulb glows in the low intensity. Replace the CH3COOH with dilute HCl, switch on the current, Now the bulb glows brightly. So here HCl solution is a strong acid and acetic acid solution is a weak acid. HCl solution produces more H plus ions or more H3O plus ions, hydronium ions. And CH3COOH acid produces favor or less H3O plus ions. Here HCl is a strong acid, CH3COOH is a weak acid. Okay students, now here the bulb glows brightly in HCl solution, while the intensity of the bulb is low, very low in CH3COOH solution. This is because HCl solution produces more H3O plus ions, but CH3COOH solution favor or less H3O plus or H plus ions. So here HCl solution produces more H3O plus ions, so it is called strong acid. CH3COOH produces less of favor H3O plus ions, it is called weak acid. Okay, here this indicates that there are more ions in HCl solution, H3O plus ions, present in HCl solution and favor ions in CH3COOH solution. Okay, so HCl solution is a strong acid and CH3COOH solution is a weak acid, okay. Again, the universal indicator, can also be used to test the strength of acid or base. The universal indicator used for the test of the acid strong or base. Universal indicator is a mixture of several indicators. The most important point, the universal indicator to test the whether acid are strong or weak. The universal indicator is a combination of mixture of several indicators. Okay, next one, pH scale means a scale for measuring the concentration of H plus ions in a given solution. A scale for measuring the concentration of H plus ions means ion produced from acid. pH scale is defined as the measuring the concentration of H plus ion in a given solution. pH scale is simply a paper, numbered paper, that number from 0 to 40. So here pH scale, a scale for measuring the hydrogen ion concentration in a solution, it is called pH scale. Okay, the pH value of neutral solution is 7. The pH value of acidic solution is less than 7. The pH value of basic solution is greater than 7. Greater than 7. Okay. What is meant by pH scale? A scale for measuring the concentration of hydrogen ion in a given solution. It is called pH scale. The pH value of neutral solution is 7. The pH value of acidic solution is less than 7. The pH value of basic solution is more than 7. The limit of the pH value from 0 to 14. This pH scale was introduced by Sorensen. pH scale was introduced by Sorensen. According to Sorensen, the definition of pH scale is, pH scale is defined as the negative logarithm of H plus ion concentration. Bracket is indicated the, here bracket is indicated the concentration. The negative logarithm of H plus ion concentration, it is called pH scale according to Sorensen definition. Okay, here 0 to 14, the new pH scale is a one number paper. The number between 0 lies between 0 to 14. Okay, here concentration of H plus ion 10 power 0. Then concentration of OH minus ions 10 power minus 14. The product between acidic ion and basic ion. Listen carefully. The concentration of H plus ions is 10 power 0. Here the concentration of OH minus ions is 10 power minus 14. These are the OH minus ion concentration. These are H plus ion concentration. The product of H plus and OH minus concentration, 10 power 0 into 10 power minus 14, that equal to 10 power minus 14. Here, the concentration of H plus ion concentration, H plus ions, 10 power minus 4. Concentration of OH minus ions, 10 power minus 10. Product between H plus ion and OH minus ion, 10 plus minus 4 into 10 plus minus 10. Basis equal exponent add 10 power minus 14. Here, H plus and concentration 10 power minus 12. OH minus concentration 10 by minus 2. 10 power minus 2. Product between H plus and OH minus 10 power minus 12 into 10 power minus 2. 10 power minus 14. That minus we take as plus or positive exponent, that is the pH value. Here pH value of H plus ions 3. Here pH value of OH minus ions 11. The product of both H plus and OH minus must be equal to 10 power minus 14. Okay, here 0 to 14 pH scale lies between numerical value of pH scale lies between 0 to 14. 0 to 6 pH value, from 0 to 6 less than 7. 0 to 6 the solutions are called acids. 0 to 6 acids. 6 acids. pH value exact 7. pH value exactly 7. Here, exactly 7. That is called neutral solution. pH value is greater than from 8 to 14. pH value greater than from 8 to 14, greater than 7, these solutions are called bases. bases. Okay, pH value from 0 to 6 are called acid, acidic solutions. Above 7 to 14, basic solution. pH value is 7. pH value is 7. It is called neutral solution. Neutral solution. Again, this acid is divided into strong acid and weak acid. Bases also divided into strong base, weak base. pH value from 0 to 3. pH value from 0 to 3. These acids are called strong acid. pH value is 2. Then the solution is called strong acidic solution. pH value 1. Then the solution is called strong acidic solution. So 0 to 3 is strong acid. 4 to 6, pH value from 4 to 6 are called weak acid. Example, acidic acid, weak acid. Okay, here from 8 to 10, 8 to 10 are called weak bases. 8 to 10 are called weak bases. From 11 to 14, pH value from 11 to 14 are called strong bases. Example, LiOH lithium hydroxide, NaOH sodium hydroxide, KOH potassium hydroxide. These are all strong bases. Some examples of weak bases: magnesium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide, aluminium hydroxide. These are all weak bases. Main example of weak base is ammonium chloride, NH4OH. Ammonium hydroxide, NH4OH. Ammonium hydroxide is a weak base. Best example of weak base. Okay, here. Now, the strength of acid or base. The strength of acid or base is dependent on the higher concentration of H3O plus ions or OH minus ions. If acid gives more H plus ions or H3O plus ions, then the acid is called strong acid. Then the base gives more OH minus ions, then the base is called strong base. Okay, here strength of acid or base, it depends on the concentration of H3O plus ions, hydronium ion, that is equal to H plus ion produced from acid. H3O plus or OH minus ions produced in a solution. Acid give more H3O plus ions, it is a strong acid. Okay, acid gives favor or lower H3O plus ions, it is a weak acid. Base give more OH minus ions, it is a strong base. pH value of strong base from 8 to 11. Base gives favor OH minus ions, it is a weak base. pH value of weak base from 8 to 11. Okay, 8 to 10. Okay, here Sorensen introduced the pH scale. According to Sorensen pH scale, the negative logarithm of H plus ion concentration, it is called pH. pH equal to not in your textbook. This equation not there in your textbook, please note. pH equal to minus log H plus ion concentration. This bracket is indicate the concentration of H plus ion concentration. Okay, student. Next one.